In Apple State, herd is being paid 100,000 naira for every cow killed during clashes. Governor Kezie Ekweazu says the same amount is also paid to farmers who have had their farmland destroyed. He says the initiative is to gain the trust of the people and to prevent them from taking the laws into their own hands. The state government has accused herders of carrying out kidnappings and of destroying farmland. We're joined now by Dr. Akin Baba Ahmed, a spokesman for the Northern Elders Forum.
Good evening and welcome to Newsnight.
Thank you very much and thank you for inviting
me. It's good to have you here. So the first thing will be, how do the elders of the northern part of Nigeria feel about all of the situation we have, all because of this issue of insecurity on the one hand, and on the other hand, Fulani herdsmen and the banditries?
Well, you might be aware that because we are from the north, we have raised our voices many, many times before about insecurity in the northern part of the country. President Buhari inherited the insurgency in the northeast and made it considerably worse. And then suddenly now, in the last 3-4 years, the north has been challenged by multiple additional threats, banditry, kidnapping, rustling. So life has become completely insecure in the northern part of the country. And we saw the beginnings of the involvement of some elements of Fulani in criminal activities way back before President Buhari became president. The signs were there, the events that were pushing the Fulani more and more into desperation were there, but the federal government, the state governments, nobody took any step to contain it. The situation on the ground now is that in the north, there is no inch of the north that is safe and secure. No citizen of the north is safe and secure. And what we lived with for the last 3-4 years, unfortunately, we're beginning to see manifested in some southern parts of the state. So criminal elements, some of them Fulani, some of them working with Fulani people, infiltrate communities, attack people, kidnap people, commit banditry, rape people, the same things where they're going on in the north. But we keep trying to remind the nation, we've lived with this, we're not defending Fulani, a lot of them are criminals, and we believe that we should throw the books at them.
And maybe that's where I should come in. I mean, you seem to have lent your voice to cause that Fulani herdsmen should move back to the northern part of the country. Is that exodus the solution to the problem? Does that not further complicate efforts to find solutions to the security crisis that Nigeria finds itself in?
Well, let me correct you there. We didn't just ask them to come back to the north. We had released two statements where we said no one has a right to eject Fulani. Fulani has a right, like every Nigerian, to live peacefully within the law. And no one has a right to eject him just for being Fulani. Mm-hmm. It is dangerous, it is illegal, and it's wrong. So we told them to stay put. But increasingly, more and more communities are assuming responsibility to eject the Fulani, to demonize him, to criminalize him. These are people that have been familiar with communities for decades and centuries. And suddenly, every Fulani is a criminal. And the state appears to have abdicated its responsibility to thugs and brigands and small little people who are chasing the Fulani all over the place. So what we said is, we demand that the Nigerian state should protect the Fulani like they're protecting everybody else. Throw the law against a Fulani man if he's a criminal, by all means. We're not defending any Fulani who's criminal. We admit there are criminal elements, both in the north and the south. But the lawful Fulani who is just earning a living, living in the south, has to be protected against people who just want to attack him for being Fulani. Now, in the event that the state refuses to do that, communities will not protect Fulani. Communities are attacking Fulani. We said then Fulani should come back to the north. And the challenge then is that northern governors, if not the federal government, have to find a way to domesticate and encourage the Fulani to stay put.
Well, Governor of Kano State, for example, Governor Ganduje, has said, you know, that the federal government should actually come up with a law banning the movement of cattle from the north to the south. And he went further to say, look, there's plenty of land in Kano. Why don't you come here and, graze and take your
cattle? I wish we had done this before people just simply started attacking Fulani for just being Fulani. The governor of Kano, this is his 6th or 7th year in being governor. He could have done some of these things a long time ago. The truth about it is that Northern leadership and the presidency have failed the Fulani. They have failed to put in place a system that will arrest and identify the criminal in the North among the Fulani, like anybody else. They haven't done that. They have, in a way, allowed the criminalization of the whole ethnic group of Fulani. And no one has a right to begin now to suggest what they should have done earlier on, just simply to make up
the Okay, now let's look at the statement of the Northern Elders Forum saying that nobody should chase Fulanis out, because it sounded like a threat when you say that don't chase them out or else your own people are not safe in the North.
Well, we didn't
is that not hitting on the point, or is that an interpretation that did not, that was not correct?
No, it didn't. We said don't chase out lawful Fulani living lawfully, respecting the law, because it is their right as a Nigerian, like every Nigerian who is in every inch and corner of the country, to live lawfully. That's what we said.
Was there any part of the statement that said that if you do, your own people are not safe?
No, nobody would do that kind of thing. We are not irresponsible. Look, we play into the hands of those who would say that kind of thing. If we fail to protect every Igbo man, every Yoruba man, every Sekiri man who's living in Jalingo, in Kano, we have to protect them. They have a right to be there. They are earning a living. They are contributing to the community. They have a right to be protected by the local community, by the state government, by the federal government. The same way that we expect people in the southern part of the country to protect the Fulani, who is respecting the law, who is not breaking any law. But there is an undercurrent that we need to watch out for. Now, when you're reading the news now, the undercurrent is people hiding behind ethnic, trying to play the ethnic card, chasing Fulani for just being Fulani, destroying their cattle, destroying their homesteads, killing them, attacking them.
Yeah, but a lot of people are confused that the body language from the leadership, whether at the president's level or even the northern elders, are not saying anything. You know, just because these people are Fulani and they're part, you know, from the president's part of the country. What do you have to say about that? Very quickly, in less than 30 seconds. And what would you say is even the way out of this problem?
Well, it's simple. Whether they come from the president's part of the country, wherever they come from, they're Nigerians. They're entitled to protection. They're entitled to being defended by a state that is where they're exposed, and no one has a right to identify a whole group and say all of you are criminals and leave. And if somebody commits a crime, we expect the law to deal with that individual and not to demonize and criminalize the whole people. This is unacceptable.
All right, we'll have to leave it there. Hakeem Babu Ahmed, spokesman for the Northern Elders Forum. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.